हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल माय ट्यूटर। एंड आज हम लोग बेसिक्स ऑफ माया में विल बी डूइंग शॉर्टकट्स एंड लर्निंग द शॉर्टकट्स व्हिच विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल व्हाइल वर्किंग इन माया। ओके, सो नाउ दोज हु हैवंट सीन माय लास्ट वीडियो अबाउट यूजर इंटरफेस, सो दे कैन हैव अ लुक। द लिंक इज गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन, यू कैन चेक इट आउट। एंड सो लेट्स स्टार्ट करते हैं। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लाइक एज आई वाज सेट लाइक अबाउट दिस सेट मेन्यू इन माय लास्ट वीडियो, सो इन दिस दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी 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 इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग, बिकॉज क्या है कि इसके ऊपर ही बहुत सारा चीज़ यहाँ पे मेन्यू में डिसाइडेड रहता है। द पर्सन हु बिलोंग्स टू मॉडलिंग, तो उसके लिए मॉडलिंग टूल्स ही ज़्यादा यूजफुल है। नाउ दिस इज द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ माया आई विल से, बिकॉज जो बंदा और द पर्सन विच बिलोंग्स टू एनी ऑफ द फील्ड, सो ही वॉट ही कैन डू इज ही कैन कस्टमाइज हिज नीड्स अकॉर्डिंगली, सो दैट इज़ द बेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ माया। ओके, सो मॉडलिंग के लिए अगर आप जाते हो तो यू विल फाइंड आफ्टर माय विंडो एंड बिफोर कैश यू विल हैव दोज मेनूज रिलेटेड टू वॉट एवर सेट मेनू इज देयर। So when I change to rigging, so you can see here, after windows and before cache, it will have only the rigging options. Check out the animation, okay? Check with the effects, check with the rendering. All right. So that is the best part of it in Maya. Now, one more in like for this, if you want to have the shortcut keys are. So, for modeling, F2 is a shortcut key. F3 is for rigging, F4 is for animation, F5 is for effects, F6 is for rendering. All these buttons deals with the set menu. Coming up to the next part is F7. F7 is actually an component mode. Okay, so for that what I'll do here is I'll just create a polygon. I just click on the polygon and this has been generated. Now, I'll just use the scale tool and make it a little bigger in size. I'll press F7. So when I click on F7, it will automatically get into a component mode. Now, this component mode is actually a multi-component mode. When I say multi-component, that means I can at any point of time, I can select face, I can select edge, I can even select a point. Okay, so this is how it is: edge, face, and point. Point means vertex. All right, and if you want to get back to object mode, press F8. So you are back to your component object mode. That means you are out of the component selection. All right, then next we have is F9, that is for vertex mode. So now you can see here. Sorry, not pressed properly. F9. So that is your vertex. You can't select anything else. So ye tumhare vertices hai. F10 is for edges. So these are the edge. Right. F11 is for face. So these are the faces. Individual face. And at the last you have F12, that is for UV. Now UV and vertex look same, but working wise both are different, and slow and steady you will come to know, okay, what is the difference between UV and vertex. Okay, all right, in short thoda sa inform kar deta hu ki UVs are nothing but the coordinates of the object, and vertex is like the component of the object. You mean differences, sir. That means when I change like for an example, when I want to deform the particular object, so with the help of vertex I can do that. Okay, but agar main UV mode pe hoon, that means I can't scale. Iska scale, move, rotate, scale se kuch bhi lena dena nahi hai. बेसिकली कोऑर्डिनेट्स है विच इज़ हेल्पफुल फॉर मैप पर्पस, यूवी टेक्सचरिंग के लिए, टेक्सचर्स के लिए, ओके टू बी वेरी प्रिसाइज. सो दैट इज देयर. देन कमिंग बैक टू ऑब्जेक्ट मोड, आई विल प्रेस F8. सो आई एम बैक टू ऑब्जेक्ट मोड. आफ्टर दैट वी हैव लाइक few more shortcut keys about I'll just go for this selection types. So press Q, that is your selection. Okay, so that is Q. W is for move, so you can find a green axis on the top, X axis as a red, Y as a green, blue as a Z. Okay, that is X, Y, Z, red, green, blue color. After that you have E for rotate, so same similar way, this is X rotation, this is Z rotation, and this one is Y rotation. Alright, so that is there. I will press undo. Undo, you can press Z tool, Z, undo as many times you want, and Shift Z for redo. Okay, just keep that thing in mind. So back here again, after that we have a scale. Scale, if you want to scale it from all the sides, center it from the center, scale it, it will scale it in a proportion. And if you want to scale it from x-axis, so this is your x-axis scale, this is your z-axis scale, and this is your y-axis scale. Okay, so that is there about Q, W, E, R. Right, after that we have like I just forgot to mention ki, like if you don't want to use those shortcuts about vertex, edges, and faces, what you can do is other option we have is a right click button of the mouse. Just right click on top of it and you will find vertices. So these are the vertices. Then we have edge, so these are the edges. Then we have face, and these are the faces. Okay, so this is the way we can get into component and come out of that component mode using object mode. All right, so that is there about QWER. And after that I have some numerical as a shortcut keys, that is 1, 2, and 3. Okay, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. I'll just do something much better. I'll just take proper. So we have a numerical shortcut keys as 1, 2, and 3. Okay. This is nothing but we call it as subdued display smoothness. So this is only for the reference purpose, ki how it will look once you applied smoothness to the object. That is the only purpose of it, number one. Number two, this is just for viewport or for the panel only. If you try to render this as an, if you think after rendering it will look sphere only, so that is not, because this this is, as I said, only and only for panel only. So this is how it looks in the output. All right. After that, back to 1. 4 is your wireframe mode. 5 is smooth shade all. 6 is actually for texture view. So what we can do here is, I'll just show you. I'll press Control A, that is for attribute editor. It is both for attribute editor as well as for channel box layer editor also. Okay, so I just click on this thing, Lambert 1. We all know by default one of the texture is assigned to each and every object which is created in Maya. So that is Lambert 1. So I'll jump onto the Lambert 1, and here we have this color option, but we are not interested in it right now. I'm much more interested in this texturing. So just click on this checker box and I'll simply assign checker box only. So here I can see here in the sample window, I can make it out checker is assigned. But in viewport, I can't see. If I render it out in render view, I can make it out. But yahan pe mujhe dikhna zaruri hai. For that purpose, press 6 as a shortcut key. And there is a key, there is a small button available on top textured. So you can have a look at that also. Okay. Now what I'll do here is I'll just go for the plane. You can make it out ki everything will be textured because as I said earlier, ki one single node is already assigned to each and every object. So that is it is due to that. Then next what we have is a 7. When I press 7 key, it is use default light or use all lights. Okay, by default, whatever light is present, it will make the make it off when as soon as you press 7, because it is actually using trying to use the light which is added extra in it. But currently there is nothing added. So what I'll do here is I'll get into rendering. I have this light option available, point light, and you can now make it out. Okay, so in each and every direction, now you can make it out. So that is the purpose of 7. So 5 default texture, that is shade view, smooth shade all. 6 is the texture, 7 is with the light. Alright, so that is there. If you want to increase or decrease the size of the gizmo, you can use minus and plus sign for increase and decrease of the gizmo. Now I'll just delete this light. I'm much more interested in this. Now what I'll do here is if you want to zoom in, zoom out or tumble. Okay, so those are the few more shortcut keys. Best part is use alt button, and you need to change only the mouse buttons. So alt plus left mouse button is tumble. Okay, alt plus middle mouse button is track, and alt plus right mouse button is dolly, that is zoom in zoom out. Okay, so this way actually you can play around with the navigation fine. And if you want to few more things also, like if you press A, so this is we call it here as A as frame all. Okay, this is frame all, view frame all. All right, and if you press F, that is frame selection. All right, now this is applicable to this window only. I'm sorry, this panel only. If I'll get into all the four panels, so what I can see here is it is like frame all. See this frame all and frame all. I'll just zoom in each and every panel. And now I'll press Shift A. So as soon as I press Shift A, the Shift A is applicable to all the panels. When I press Shift F, that is frame selection for all the panels again. Okay, so that is how to use it. Choose it accordingly. Okay, so F is, as I said, frame selection, and Shift F is frame selection for all the panels or all the viewports. A is for frame all. Okay, so for one viewport, and Shift A for all the panels or all the viewports. All right, if you want to make a duplicate, so you can press Ctrl D as a duplicate. And if in case if you want to have a duplicate at certain distance, with the distance whatever value you have copied, so use Shift plus D, that will be duplicate with transform. All right, that is a shortcut key for that. After that, we have The last command repeat is G, whatever short you have used. Like for an example, I'll just use it in this case. I'll just right click, select the face, and I'll press Control E, that is for extrude. Okay, so now if I would like to use the same shortcut key again, so I can just press G as a last command tool repeat, and I can use it as many times as I want it. So that is the purpose of using G. It is basically repeating the last command. Okay, so back here again, and what else? Yeah, if you wish to change the background color of the panel, you can press Alt plus B. Go on pressing, it will change the color of the background. Okay, this is something very interesting, which you can use it as per your look and feel basically. Okay, after that we have, we can do snapping also. Currently snapping is here. This option is snap to grids. Click here, you can find the circle in the center. So this is snapping as per the grid. Right now we have snap to point, that is for vertex. Now if I wish to like, you can see here this axis, x-axis is selected. I'll just go for this axis now, and x and y plane, that is sorry, x and z plane. And I would like to like focus, I would like to snap this box to this vertices object. So now you can see here it is getting snapped to those points only. I'll press 4. So now you can make it very clear how it is getting snapped. We have edge also. I'll just make it on and off. So you can, this. Okay. So that is how this snapping can be used. Shortcut key for on the edge is C. You can hold on C. If you want vertex to be, you can hold the V button for snapping with the points. And for C for this edges. Okay, it is on this side. So accordingly, it will get snapped. Okay, so for after that, there are many many shortcuts like as per the requirement, which we will learn. But the shortcuts which I shared with you, these are some of the shortcuts which is regularly used while working, and that's it. So guys, those who are new to the software, ये वीडियो जो है स्पेशली उन लोगों के लिए ही बनाया हुआ है, एंड इट इज़ मेड फॉर देम ओनली. सो प्लीज़ शेयर द वीडियो विथ योर फ्रेंड्स, दोज हु आर लाइक न्यू टू द माया सॉफ्टवेयर. एंड जितना ज़्यादा हो सके उतना शेयर कीजिए, लाइक कीजिए. ओके, एंड सो दिस वॉज जस्ट एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ यूजर इंटरफेस एंड शॉर्टकट कीज फॉर न्यू यूजर्स टू माया. आई एम कमिंग अप विथ वन मोर basic video where I will show you how to use modeling toolkit in Maya. Don't forget to subscribe my channel for upcoming videos of modeling toolkit in Maya and many more. I hope you have understood the user interface of Maya and necessary shortcut keys in Maya, and I believe you like the video. Click on thumbs up or like and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for new updates. If any queries, write it in the comment box. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग माई वीडियो. मिलते हैं कुछ और एक्स्ट्रा टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स के साथ अगले वीडियो में. थैंक यू.